discuss the solution of the given question. Here, what is the given question? Which of the following is correct? Option A is 101 whole power 100 greater than 100 power 101. Option B, 26 power 25 less than 25 power 26. Option C, 300 power 299 less than 299 power 300, like the D. Here, what is the observation we can do here? The observation is mainly, suppose if you assume this 100 as n. So n plus 1, how much? 101. This is n plus 1. Similarly, this is n, 25, 26. Similarly, 299, 300. Like that, 198, n. N plus 1, 199. Powers also the same. This is n plus 1, this is n. This is n plus 1, this is n. This is n plus 1, this is n. Similarly, n plus 1, n. See, let me write the generalized idea of the above options. Let me write that options. Here, what is that? N plus 1 whole power n, which is greater than or less than n power n plus 1. See, all of the options are of the form this one. Now, I would like to calculate. See, suppose if I calculate this by this one. This by means n plus 1 whole power n by n by n. By n power n plus 1, if it is less than 1, I can write some conclusions from that. First, let me calculate the fraction of these two. N plus 1, right, whole power n by n power n plus 1. And now, which is equals to n plus 1 whole power n by, let me write the power n, n power n into n, which is equals to 1 by n into n plus 1 whole power n by n power n, now which is equals to 1 by n. So I can write this as 1 plus 1 by n whole power n, means n plus 1 by n, means n by n 1, 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. This is the form, this is the final form of this one, n plus 1 whole power n by n power n plus 1. Now, have you observed only this part? Yes, in the calculus we have one formula. What is that formula? As n tends to infinity, as n tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by n whole power n equals to e. This is the value of e. E is always lies between 2 to 3. So I can write 2 less than e less than 3. This is the conclusion. This is IITJ advanced question. Now from this implies 2 less than, what is e? 1 plus 1 by n whole power n less than e. Keep in mind, n tends to infinity, n should be indefinitely large. Now, this implies, but we require 1 by n into 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. Multiply it 1 by n on both sides. So, 2 by n less than 1 by n into 1 plus 1 by n whole power n less than, see, sorry, this is 3. Now, 3 by n. Now finally I got this form. So this implies 2 by n less than 1 by n into 1 plus 1 by n whole power n less than 3 by n. I want this expression either less than 1 or greater than 1. Suppose if I take n greater than 3, it should be a less than 1. For n greater than 3. See, if you take 4, 3 by 4 is always less than 1. Now, from these two, I got a conclusion. What is the conclusion? See, this implies 1 by n into 1 plus 1 by n whole power n less than 1. From this, I can write one conclusion. What is the conclusion? See, this equals to this one. What is the assumed one? N plus 1 whole power n. N plus 1 whole power n by n power n plus 1. N power n plus 1, which is less than 1. This implies n plus 1 whole power n, which is less than n power n plus 1 for n greater than 3. This is the final conclusion. Now, let's compare with our available options. See, n plus 1 whole power n, which is less than, but this is greater than, this is incorrect. Here, n plus 1 less than is there, this is correct. And next, third one, 300 less than, n plus 1 less than n, means n plus 1 whole power n less than n power n plus 1, this is also correct, this is also, which is equals to, is there, this is incorrect. Only the possible options are B and C. The answer is B comma C. B comma C. See, it is a multi-correct. This is IIT JEE advanced question. So at last we got this conclusion. What is the key concept we used here? Only we used the key concept limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n over power n equals to e, and then we multiplied with 1 by n. Finally we got this result. All the best. Thanks for watching.